Roger, why are you not wearing a face mask?
Okay, there are a couple of reasons. One of them is that part of the, in fact, the major reason to wear a face mask is to protect you from infecting you. I had my test yesterday and it's negative.
Okay. That's a very good answer.
You have a great respect for authority, for leadership. We worship individualism.
That is the kind of change in mindset of open-minded humanitarian approach.
新冠疫情之下，要不要戴口罩成为了一个问题。对于亚洲人来说，戴口罩是理所当然的。不过在欧美国家，戴口罩却有可能被羞辱，甚至是遭到人身攻击。在口罩问题的背后，究竟暗藏着哪些东西方的文化差异呢？孙老师，我知道您是3月18号刚刚才从美国回来，因为我们看到其实就是短短的这样两周的这个时间，从最早美国的这个70个病例，再到700、7000，然后占到全球整个新冠肺炎的1/4的这样一个人数，为什么这样的事情会发生在美国？
据我在当时在美国的观察以及现在的理解来看呢，我觉得确实就出在美国他自己的管理上。我在美国那段时间呢，美国实际上并不是那么太高度的警惕，甚至于我在纽约机场啊，就准备登机回北京的时候，我就看到纽约机场的人都不戴口罩。甚至我问他们，我说为什么你们都不戴口罩啊？他们好像都不当回事，摇摇头，觉得无所谓。当时我开车经过纽约的时候，也看了看纽约城里面的这个路上的走的人，大概除了个别亚裔人可以戴着口罩，基本上都没戴口罩。而且他们的生活方式，一般来说戴口罩都是有病人才戴口罩，没有病人戴口罩是很奇怪的。所以呢，他们觉得这个东西不太适合他们的生活方式。但正是由于这么一种管理上的这种疏忽啊，导致了非常容易迅速的被感染。
Do you think there is an awareness issue with the public? Are people getting used to the idea of wearing masks?
In Asia, for various reasons, wearing a mask is seen almost as a social norm. In the US, people that wear masks are sometimes stigmatized and may be even directly criticized or sometimes even physically attacked for wearing a mask. And there are different reasons behind this.But I think the first step, of course, is official government guidance. And we can see here that that the federal government has not clearly come out one way or the other. I think the latest headlines are that the White House or the federal government is considering advising people to wear masks. Even with a seemingly simple decision, it seems like, you know, the U.S. is struggling.With a view of what to do.
您看，从中国成功的控制了这个第一阶段的疫情发展之后，到其实到整个东亚，在这次防控当中做的都相当好，也有一些学者在总结这样的一些成功的防控经验。您会如何来看待
呢？我觉得东亚呢，因为这个社会已经习惯了这样的集体生活了，所以东亚社会在这些问题上一直做得比较好的。如果你把历史看长一点来说，在历史上。曾经有过多次这种大型的瘟疫，比如说这个黑死病、鼠疫，曾经也是从欧洲到亚洲，中国就是比他们处理得好。中国人知道一发生瘟疫的时候你应该怎么做，你应该自我隔离。孔子的时候，孔子的那个时代，春秋战国的时代，他的学生病了，孔子去了以后就是在外头打一个作揖
啊。从那个时候，
就我们有这习惯，就知道就是怎么样对付这样的事儿的时候。中国人很早就发明了要烧水吃，而在这个欧洲，他们从来都是井水打上来就喝的。然后过去在瘟疫流行的年代，他们那儿一死就是几千万人的死亡，所以生活习惯、社会组织、社会制度都起很大的作用。
So the majority of the population in certain countries just don't seem to care as much.They don't care about wearing masks, and they think it's no big deal, right? Even President Trump made comments such as these. But in East Asia, people have a much better attitude about mask wearing, about complying with travel restrictions, and people are more understanding the government's policies.
Well, you know, in 1992, there was a famous book called Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus. I'm mentioning that,because we have the same distinctions between Asian cultures and, let's say, American or some Western cultures. In your region of the world, you're a Confucian-oriented societies. you have great respect for authority, for leadership, and so on. You've had for thousands of years. In America, we're more typified by our American president of 120 years ago, Theodore Roosevelt, who was called a rugged individualist. So we worship individualism.
Those Asian countries with this Confucian culture, people are much more open to accepting that they have to act together to meet a common crisis. And in addition, they're much more open to taking, in an emergency situation, very stringent directives from their government. That does not happen in Europe and North America, which I think explains why Europe and North America and the high-income countries have been much slower to react to this crisis. You know, the EU countries are not acting in cohesion at the moment. Italy appealed for help. None of the other EU countries would support it. That is the kind of change in mindset, of open-minded humanitarian approach, is crucial if this pandemic is going to be successfully conquered by the world.